What's up, guys, and welcome back to Earth Zero. I'm your host, Black Nick, and I am so disappointed with Rocksteady, guys. I'm sure you guys heard about this $200 million loss of the game. That is just sad. And it's just like more information has just been coming out now recently about this game, and I just don't understand who sat there and thought that this game was a better choice than sticking to their single player game roots, dude. Greediness will bite you. Greediness will bite you, guys. And we're seeing the results with Suicide Squad and all these companies that like are really good at single player games, and all these companies that think like, oh yeah, now we need to start going towards the live service side of games to make money, just because of games like Fortnite and Helldivers 2 that have, you know, cracked the code and have done well. And now all these other gaming companies that are so good at making good single player experiences are trying to follow suit out of greediness, and it's just terrible, dude, because you're not even doing the formula properly, and it's just nonsense, guys. But anyway, if you're new to the channel, please hit that like and subscribe button. So I've played Suicide Squad. Unfortunately, I don't have footage for you. If you want to see footage, you're going to have to go to my Twitch account, which is BlackNick9. Please follow me on Twitch as well if you want to see some of my gameplay. I have played the whole game. I'm not just ranting like some people that haven't played the game. But I never paid full price for the game, guys. The game was on sale, and my friend and I game share on PlayStation. Thank you, PlayStation, for game sharing. So we basically went, got the game for 25%, dude. Basically, of its normal price, we got it for 25%. So that's a bargain on our end. But I still have bad things to say about the game, even though we got it super, super cheap, you know. It's just still not it, dude. After playing the game, I can understand and see why people are just frustrated. So there are good things about it, and there are aspects about it that I really wish worked, you know, and that everyone was playing on it, I mean on the game, and it was just hyped and everyone was having a good time and we had a good actual live service superhero game. It would have been great. I also wished that happened for Marvel's Avengers, but it's all that greediness and that money and the lack of content that both companies failed. But Suicide Squad is getting more backlash from me compared to Marvel's Avengers, because those people never worked on a live service game before. No one really knew, you know, no one really, it was just a new kind of thing, you know. They didn't have backgrounds on working on Marvel games. It was just a new thing. They were trying it out. They weren't good at it. I don't think they're going to go back. But Suicide Squad Kill the Justice League had that game for as an example of what they shouldn't do. And then they land up doing the same thing, but just even worse, bro. So I'm going to just talk about like a quick review of the game. I thought in terms of cutscenes, the cutscenes look really good. I liked what Metropolis looked like. It looks really good. It's like some childhood cool stuff, you know, like that they brought to the table. So I was really, really happy with the map, the cutscenes. I like the boss fights as well. You know, some of the boss fights were really like cool to see, like Superman going around. That was really cool. I like Green Lantern a lot. The Flash, also semis. The Flash and Superman were the same, but it was just cool seeing Superman there swinging big things at you. Like, they were really cool all in all. Batman, they did dirty, bro. Batman just, that upset me a lot, dude. Batman is boss fight, and the way they treated him was just terrible, dude. Sweet Baby Ink, you guys have some other vibes going on, dude. That's why people are angry with your writing, because it was just terrible, dude. Like, Batman got punched in the face, got killed in the middle of the park somewhere. Felt like someone that had proper passion and hate for some of these Justice League members made this game, dude, you know. Like, killing them is one thing, and then spitting on them, peeing on them, and whatever. And it's just like, the game doesn't make you resonate enough with the actual main characters for you to be on their side, to be doing it to characters that you actually do like, you know? So all in all, it was just such a bad vibey game. But the gameplay was just lacking, dude. The gameplay is so copy and paste. After the first day of playing the game, I was just like, I'm already feeling what I felt like 2 months down the line from Marvel's Avengers, that repetitive vibe. I felt that like within the first like day of playing the game, dude. But and also because it's just one big map of Metropolis, doesn't seem like a lot is changing. At least in Marvel's Avengers, we got a snow map, a desert map, you know, certain things just started coming out, you know. I know it's still too early to compare it, but I still think at the beginning we got a lot of different looking maps compared to this game, dude, where it's just Metropolis, you know, and some of these walls and buildings all look the same, and you just get bored eventually of just flying back and forth doing these missions on repeat that are all kind of copy and paste in their own way, you know. So the game after like two days just started feeling like a chore to me. Gameplay doesn't even help it. I think they ruined their gameplay by just giving everyone guns, dude. None of the characters feel unique unless you use their ultimates, and obviously their melees are a bit different, but all in all the guns just ruin it, you know. Like in Marvel's Avengers, when you play as Iron Man, you can only do things that Iron Man does, shoot out lasers. Imagine Iron Man, like there's like, imagine they use the same formula in Marvel's Avengers, and then now Iron Man can use a gun, but we also have Winter Soldier. Like, how would that make Winter Soldier look any good if Iron Man can also just use a gun, you know? Like, I just don't understand how did they not apply that same concept. Plus, we limited to 4 characters only. And it's just like, you know, everyone approached this game with the same mindset that they had with Marvel's Avengers. And you went out and still released the same kind of game, dude. So all in all, I would just say it's a 6.5 for me, solid. It's not terrible like everyone says it's a 3. I can still give it like a little breather. But if you do compare it to like Arkham Knight, then it's like probably in the 4s and the 3s too. Because not Arkham Knight and the whole Arkham trilogy is just up there, dude, compared to this game. This game just looks like they just wanted to follow suit with other companies, be greedy, try and make cash over a long time by putting in minimal effort. And this is the problem that I have with these live service superhero games, dude. They approach it like, oh yeah, because it's DC and because it's Rocksteady or because it's Marvel's Avengers, they're gonna make loads of cash on day one, and then with that cash they're gonna carry on working on the content that is gonna come out later on. But all in all, you should have the roadmap done for the game before you release it. You should have all that content already there so that you have a backup plan when it doesn't make the money and you can show you putting in the effort and stuff. But because of this whole backlash and them losing $200 million, dude, that is sad, dude. Warner Bros. Is probably gonna like let some people go off, you know, like they're gonna let some people go loose, I have a feeling, dude, because that is just terrible. That's a lot of money for a game, bro. It's bad enough for when movies do it. Imagine a game, bro. So I feel bad for those people now, but I actually don't at the same time, because it was just dumb for whoever thought that this game would be better than a single player game, bro. But all in all, they should always have things for when, I mean, the game should have just been done already, right? And then they release out their sections so that if something like this happened, they could still be on the ball and have their stuff up to date, such as like Helldivers. Helldivers has a battle pass every single like month almost, dude. Like, I've just been seeing them releasing battle passes every month, you know. And it's just like they are invested, they're online and they're talking to their fans, they're hearing what issues are there, and then they're on it, dude, and they're replying, they're like, we hear you and everything. With Suicide Squad and Marvel's Avengers, nowhere to be seen, dude, because they're obviously still working on whatever the problem they have with the gamers, and they have the pressure from the fans, so they're deciding to ignore the fans, which just shows me that their game wasn't complete initially. They just got up to this point, and then they were like, okay, we'll do the rest later. Let's just see how much we actually make money out of this, you know. And then we'll start working on all of that stuff. And now it's just pressure and your game looks like a total disaster and flopped, dude. You know, if you weren't stingy and greedy, you'd already have it in the bag. And then it wouldn't take so long for each season to come out so that people, you won't go through these droughts and periods of no players, if you get what I'm saying, dude. So in all, that's the problem I have with these live service games, is where they're like greedy with the rest of the content and story content for extra money, but they basically haven't even worked on it. So you haven't even finished your game, and then you're relying on the day one money for us to pay for only that 30% of the storyline. And then the rest is going to come out, you know, later on while you're just trying to scam us with more money, you know, for either skins, suits, and all of that. And speaking about skins and suits, this game is so bad at that, dude. If you do not pay for the battle pass, you, like, can only earn in 4 in-game skins or suits for each character. And they're not even good. Some of them are just reskin colors. Some of them just have little kryptonite on it, dude. It's just like, it's so bad if you don't put in money towards the actual skins, dude. So it doesn't feel like you're grinding towards anything. It doesn't feel like you're earning anything. The battle pass apparently takes, like, when I came on, it said 80 days left until the next battle pass. So I only got the game like 2 or 3 weeks after. So that means it's more days than that the battle pass is gonna last until the next one comes out. And it's just like, why is it that long to grind out a battle pass like that, dude? And it's just like, it's so long, and the gameplay doesn't even help sustain it in terms of fun and that you want to do it. And it doesn't matter how long the battle pass does, you know, you just feel like you're not earning. It feels like homework now. So I've uninstalled the game. I'm not playing that game at all. And it's just like, it's just a bad disaster, dude. Like, how do you think from the Arkham games to this was going to be good? To this coin shooting out of people, all these lights flickering kind of game. Like, people took the Arkham game seriously because it had that serious tone. It was, like, realistic in terms of the characters. Now we're going around with jetpacks going, woohoo, doing backflips, woohoo. Everyone using snipers, coins coming out of character, out of these enemies and stuff, dude. And excuse the noises, my street is very busy today. But anyway, it's just like everything was just taken from these standards, and we wanted like these standards. If we got the exact same standards and got like a single player Batman game, it was still okay. I still think people would still be happy that it's another Batman game, compared to like going all the way down here, if you know what I'm saying. Like, they didn't even upgrade, they went down and stooped low in this game, dude. And it's just, it's not fun for anyone. You're not receiving or gaining anything. It's too grindy, it's too copy and paste. And it's just sad that you have to pay the most amount of money compared to someone who's going to get it for half price down the line, and you get less amount of content than they get, you know, or less amount of, you know, everything in general, dude. And it's like, you paying them so that you can fix their game, dude. Tell them what issues they have, tell them what skins you want and all of that stuff, and then they do it all later on. But it's just like, no, Helldivers came and they were like, this is our game. Then they heard feedback, and then they're adding that feedback or doing those things from the feedback, but they already had their game done and had given they all into the game that you purchased for. Second of all, they didn't even ask you for $70. It was cheaper than $70 because they knew the worth of their game. And it's just fun all in all. People have been playing that day and night, and it's just like, you can just tell the difference between a greedy game where they're trying to milk brainwashed fanboys, compared to a game where they're just like, this is our game, this is what we thought fans will be having fun with. And I'll show you why we want a single player game. A really good example is Ghost of Tsushima. For Ghost of Tsushima, I paid less than $60 for that game when it came out, because the prices for those games weren't that high at that point. I still got 70 hours plus from just the base game. Then all I had to do was add in like an extra, like, you know, $10 or so, or $20 to just upgrade to the like director's cut. Then they still gave me a whole DLC. They still gave me online mode with free cosmetics, free everything, with extra modes and an extra storyline. So you get more DLC content that like lasts 30 hours, depending if you do everything. 30 hours long, and you still get an online mode with another storyline for online mode that you can play with your friends on heaps on end, and still earn free stuff in all these modes. Everything was just free, dude. The only thing you had to pay for was access to those things. And it's just like, can you tell when a game is not greedy and when they have passion for their game and want people to actually enjoy, how the differences between these live service games and this game, dude? So I basically paid $70 all in all for Ghost of Tsushima. I got the base game, I got a DLC for it, and I got online mode, and I didn't have to pay anything else ever again. No cosmetics, nothing, dude. That's people that are willing to make their fans happy. But Rocksteady was just like, oh, we got our grasp in superhero stuff. They've seen how the superhero fan base is when it comes to their games, and they thought that we were just going to let them go, dude. And whoever worked there and wasn't a part of this, or like the people that left and they weren't agreeing with what they were wanted to do from Rocksteady, I'm happy with you guys for like standing your ground and leaving and not joining this backlash of the game. You guys are the real ones, because you thought from a consumer's perspective. These people thought from a cash grab, how can we milk these stupid fans kind of perspective, dude. And now you've got minus 200 million, dude. And it's so sad on Instagram is so bad for them, dude. I went onto the Instagram page, and all they're posting on there is the same weapons that you have already seen 200 times from unlocking it throughout the missions. I keep getting the same weapons that they're showing me in their new Instagram post. Old cutscenes from the base game, XP boost weekends. That's the only thing that they can update the game with, and they have nothing about Season 2. Nothing about other seasons. They actual Instagram page is so dry right now, dude. And it's just like, what are they doing, dude? Like, I literally pictured it as like some of these guys that are doing the marketing and social side of things, like sitting outside of work kicking grass. Then this guy comes out the office, and then they're like, oh, Max, oh, is there something new that we can post about the next season? Oh, not yet. You can still post about the Superman fight again. You can just post a little clip from that right now. Just like, okay, but where are you going? Oh, I'm going to the movies with my girlfriend, but aren't you supposed to be working on season two? Season two, basically. And it's like, oh, no, Max is actually working on season two. And it's just like, but it's only you and Max. That's only one person. And it's just like, well, the salary we're getting from this game is only worth one person, so he can work on the rest of it. That's how it feels like. It feels like there's only three people that are working on it right now, dude. Where are all these people from the videos and stuff that were hyping it up and saying it was going to be great and everything? Why aren't they working? Why isn't there a department that works on skins so that the store looks good? Why isn't there a department working on new enemies? Why isn't there a department making the locations and the maps look different so that it feels like we playing in different areas and different things? Just spray painting walls as Joker is not gonna cut it, dude. And then the number one thing from this video that I can say is that I read an article from Game Rant, and apparently Rocksteady went to WB and said that they wanted to make a live service game. The executives and everything actually didn't come into the game and say, no, you need to make this a live service game. Apparently Rocksteady themselves went and said, we want to make this a live service game, dude. And whoever did that or made that idea, he should be the one penalized first before you remove anyone else in the company, dude. The person that said, yes, I wanted to be a live service and came with the idea, that person should be removed instantly, because that was the dumbest idea. Now you've lost 200 million. You pissed off fans. There's not enough skins. There's nothing to grind right now. The game is on drought. You have only 100 players left on Steam playing this at a time. It's looking bad. You're not going to come back from this. And if you're still going to follow the same roadmap of putting in small content, you're going to just get two or three people coming on. Your Instagram page only has like 50,000 followers so far. I remember the last time I saw it was on 49,000. It might still be at 49,000. So I'm just saying it's at 50,000 followers so far. And I don't think they got anything right now besides you releasing Deathstroke and making him look badass and putting in actual good story content into it. There's nothing that can revive the game. Actually, one thing some person pointed out is that you should just release all the roadmaps at once. Release all the roadmaps at once, charge it as a full game, and then just pull the plug, dude. Just give us that offline mode. Let people play the full game with all the content you're supposed to release all at once, and then just pull the plug, dude. Because this whole 80 days between each next battle pass and next thing is not gonna save your game at all, dude. Unless that season has some miraculous new guns, new gameplay, new enemies, new looking good locations, and something that can keep you occupied and make us see that, oh yeah, this the future for this game is bright. But from what I'm seeing on social media and just the lack of feedback, there's no redeeming this game. It's like done. It's done, dude. So that was my rant about the game. Disappointed in Rocksteady. Any live service game coming from Rocksteady going forth, or any WB games, Rocksteady, I'm definitely not buying them on day one. I'm happy I didn't buy this game on day one. I'd feel so terrible right now still playing this game, and I paid $100 for it, dude. With that $100, you could have bought so many other better games at half price right now. You could probably buy like 3 half price games right now. That will give you more content and better gameplay than this game and keep you occupied. You could have bought 3 other games with that $100, but you decided to invest it in a game that doesn't give zero damns about what their fan base has been saying. They're all quiet, they're all devastated and traumatized, and I just have the feeling that the plug is going to get pulled, and that low-key we were all duped of our money, dude. Anyway. Sorry, DC fans. I love you guys all. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.